All right, so this one's going to be a little bit more of a fun one. These are the next two are videos that were deleted off of TikTok and gave me violations because I hurt someone's feelings. This one's called It's Cadney, Bitch. And it's the first one. And then later we're going to go to A Wild Vicky T Appears. It's very curious that these two were removed. I wonder whose feelings I hurt. Then we're going to go into a deep dive series of Cade Hudson and his background. It is from about here, 6 minutes in, all the way down to when I start freaking out about the Britneys at 19 minutes. So it's about a 12-minute segment. Then you can skip this or watch it, me freaking out about realizing they're deepfakes for 12 minutes. Then I go into, isn't it curious that some of the older photos of Britney kind of look like Faye, Asghari, Sam's sister who he seems to really love. Then we have the Sam Asghari deep dive, again, going with him and Faye again, because I think they're creepy. And that goes on for about, it's about like 10 minutes. And then there's Sam Asghari about community property. Then about, is Sam forcing Britney to model clothes all the way to the end? And I particularly like the last, 4 minutes. It's talking about the conservatorship, Britney Spears, that she was never crazy, etc. Enjoy. And also, Cadney, Vicky, try to get this removed. Fuck you, it's not gonna happen. Vicky T, you're annoying.
This is Cade Hudson. Cade's got some dark eyes, because you know why? He's a mega Hollywood agent. That man works. That's a man's man. Ladies and gentlemen, if you're single and ready to mingle and you like a side of sexual assault, this guy's for you. It's not everyone's kink. I know, I get it. But for those of you who do like it, that's a sexual assaulter. They kind of look alike. I never noticed. What a striking resemblance. You know, men own up their shit. When he got accused of sexual assault, he didn't say, not me. Mm-mm. He said, yeah, it was me. But I thought she was my friend. You liked my Facebook post. That she was my friend. We laughed it off. I said, can I suck your dick? And you said, what? And I went, just kidding, no homo. And then we laughed it off and you liked my Facebook post. So, ladies and gentlemen, that's a real man, okay? He owns his shit. Yeah, he's an assaulter. The best of them are. Look at the Epstein book. The best of them are. Real men assault.
I still think it's an innocent video. I don't know why they removed it.
So I want to talk to you guys about a couple of things. You know, there's apps that you can use on your phone that you can just swap people's faces. I think this one's called Reface. So pretty easy. That's Cade's face on Britney. So this is what Cade would look like if he was wearing Britney's face. So this is deep fake Britney using Cade as the green screen. That's Cade's face on Britney again. Notice his nose is kind of long. You know what I mean? So it's a little long. This is Britney's face on Cade. Notice that her nose is smaller. Did you see how her nose kind of shrunk in on his face? There's even apps that you can use like this that will make a picture animate. Kind of crazy, right? Look at that. That doesn't even look like me. Here we go again. Now, we switch their faces again. Britney has bigger eyes. It looks like it. Cade's eyes are smaller and he has these deep-seated bags here. Cade's nose is longer on Britney's face. Britney's nose is smaller in Cade's face. Why am I showing you this? Oh, this was a good one. Look at the nose. You see the nose? Yeah. Yeah. The nose kind of reminds me, I don't want to say it. I guess I have to. A little bit of whoever the fuck this is.
But you guys remember the piano reflection video right up here? Guess who stopped by in the comments? Would you look at that? A wild Vicky T just popped out of the comments section saying, like, dude, the reflection totally matches. And then somebody liked it. Person, do you know who Vicky T is? I'm not saying anything, but I would literally just do the opposite.
Honestly, person who liked the Vicky T comment, I'm judging your fucking ass, though.
So what she said, Britney's safe? Britney's not safe, everybody. Like, that's what I'm getting from this, okay?
I mean, nothing validates you more than someone in Team Khan saying, hey, I think you're wrong.
Aren't you the villain? And they're like, yeah, and I think you're wrong. So shouldn't I just do the opposite of what you said? What? No, that's not my plan. Vicky T was Britney Spears' assistant for that weird period when she got out of the conservatorship, and she was like, I'm free, y'all. And then we're all like, but are you, bitch? And then we're like, I don't know, seems sus. And then she got married, and we're all like, oh my God, I don't think that bitch was ever free. And that's where we're at. So she commented not once, not twice, but four fucking times being like, Britney's free. I worked with her for a year. Britney's free. So you worked for her a year ago. Yeah. So you know that she's currently free.
Yeah.
How the fuck does that logically make sense? Have you seen her in a year?
No.
Only the deepfakes of her. Bitch. Shut the fuck up. Jesus. Also, Vicky T's daddy is, or was, the CEO of Sony for, like, a long-ass time. I think, like, 20 years.
Total speculation, but the, you know, Break the Ice video, the villain kind of looked like Vicky T's dad. Just saying.
Especially during Britney's era. Nothing says nepo baby and handler much more than, you know, daddy being the CEO of Sony. Just saying. Britney Spears' recording company, by the way, is Sony. Wonder how Vicky T got that job. I wonder if there was an extensive interview process. You know, most crime families, they have a motto, which is, let's keep it all in the family. Not saying Sony's a crime family. I'm just saying it's starting to really look like that in all of Hollywood. Just saying. And Vicky T. You weren't even on my fucking radar, bitch, or list. But guess who is now? You are. You're gonna zoom on in front of a couple other people I was gonna do videos about? I'll do you first. Don't you worry, because you've piqued my interest. You and your daddy. Thank you so much for your ill attempt to make me feel less validated, which actually validated me. Who sent you, bitch? Was it Sammy? Was it Cadney? Who has the wallet now? I'm sorry, it was probably Lou Taylor. Well, you tell Lou we say hello back and go fuck yourself. Because until this woman fucking goes on a live or speaks or does something that makes us go, okay, we'll take it. I don't fucking think we're gonna back the fuck down now, are we? Meant to record this on the 4th of July, which was yesterday, and say, hey, happy independence, everyone. Do you know who doesn't have independence? Britney Spears from the conservatorship. Exactly. Let's get into it. But today's July 5th, so fuck it. I like it. Let's just pretend that was yesterday. And I'm just gonna add this in here as like a little ad lib at the end, as like a little joke. Because it doesn't really fucking make sense otherwise, right? Also, it's my friend Caroline's birthday, so public shout out. Happy birthday. You're old now. Sorry. So somebody asked me to make commentary on this, so that's why this video is here. I'm not usually a person that's like, fuck you, fuck you. I mean, sometimes. Depends on the occasion. You guys are like Britney Spears' OG fans. You guys have her back. The way you guys came for Vicky T in the comments section, that's loyalty. That's love. You guys should be proud of yourself. You know who don't have loyalty? And this is a side note, just Selena's friends. Every time like I read an article, they're like, there's Hailey Bieber or Selena's best friend from childhood. I'm like, what the fuck are you doing, bitch? But you know, now seeing how Selena handled this whole Britney's thing, it's like, maybe you deserve it, bitch. I don't know. But one has to wonder why none of your friends have any fucking loyalty. 9 out of 10 times, the answer is you, bitch. So maybe it is. And plus, the way you don't have Britney's back, maybe you don't deserve that loyalty. Just saying.
So who the fuck is Cade Hudson? Well, I'll tell you. So today is Wednesday, March 8th, 2023. A little past midnight. Last night, Tuesday, March 7th, Britney posted this picture of this guy. Cade Hudson, not to be confused with Kate Hudson. She labeled it with the caption, my friends know serious shit. That's peculiar. I'm assuming she means that this motherfucker is a shit talker. Like, to have articles like this, you need a fucking source, because defamation still fucking exists. TMZ articles. Basically, you can't post shit unless there's a source. So there has to be a leak, or there has to be someone making shit up. Like, there has to be a fucking pipeline. Where does TMZ get the articles? Interesting note. Britney Spears' best friend, supposedly. He's been her agent for the last 12 years. Why 12 years? Well, if you guys don't remember, back in 2010, Britney was engaged to this guy. His name is Jason Trollick. I don't really know much about him, but from what I'm reading and what I'm understanding, he seems like a piece of shit too. Let's go into it. This man was engaged to her pretty much during the years where Britney looked like she was being worked to death. It was the, I don't even know what fucking album it is. It was the one after Circus. It was the Femme Fatale one. It was a bunch of the dancey songs. Hold It Against Me Till the World Ends. Honestly, everything post-conservatorship has never reached the peak of Blackout, which has been, I gave Blackout another listen just like last year. Damn, that shit's a banger.
That whole fucking album is so fucking strong. She was so fucking ahead of her league. She like was tapping into EDM before EDM was even a thing. You know, on our artistic level, fuck you, everyone in the conservatorship. You have ruined a piece of music. You stifled her. It's her magnum opus, okay? You can tell the creativity was just flowing, okay? Donja, her beautiful magic. I think Carrie Hilson was there too as a songwriter. Fucking magic, okay? Anyway, so he was at the peak of her being overworked. He got together a little bit after she was on Glee. Big agent. I think he reps Taylor Swift now. He's also currently Paris Hilton's agent. Weird. He works at WME. That's going to be important later. So his best friend is this guy, Cade Hudson. He asked his friend Cade to take over as her agent. All right, that seems like normal enough, right? And here, by the way, Jason still represents Paris Hilton. Just interesting. His friend Cade Hudson works at CAA, Creative Artist Agency. It's one of the big ones. WME is big. CAA is big. There's some other ones that are like smaller. You don't need a manager in Hollywood, but you definitely need an agent. They broker deals and, you know, they get 10% commission. You could have a manager. Managers typically make 5%. A manager kind of like dictates where your career is going to go and what you're going to do. And then I was an assistant for an agent for a little bit. And what they pretty much do is take a bunch of executive lunches. I'll be back in 2 hours. I'm getting lunch with someone from Fox. I don't give a shit. All right. So like, do you want me to forward your calls or what the fuck do you want me to do? Jesus fuck. 2007, 2012. That's when he was there. So he was here before the conservatorship and after its conception. And he said, like, oh, he also, like, applauds Jamie and says Jamie had her best intention. And goes, unless they're going to sit down and prove he stole money. They did. Jason, they fucking did. Which makes me wonder, did you steal some money too? This is the worst line about Jason Trawick. Jamie, thrilled. Thrilled why? It's all in the family. Jamie's thrilled. All in the family. My thinking is all in the family means you're all in cahoots. And now it's a kind of a closed circuit, the family. Anybody that Jamie fucking Spears likes should not be trusted. By the way, Sam was also approved by Jamie. I don't know. That's like a video we need to talk about. I have the whole ass video for that next time, right? Like, no one has this woman's fucking interest, okay? Like, she's got a golden fucking heart. And y'all are just like, how much money can she fucking make me? People can make fucked up decisions. You could, like, literally be a drug addict. And no one's gonna put you in a conservatorship. But if you're making money for a lot of people, hey, I think you need to be conservatorship because now your reckless choices are fucking me up with my money. Let's talk Kanye, okay? That motherfucker says the craziest fucking shit. We all know that Kim and fam, at one point, when they were married, were worried about, like, you know, what he was saying. So they wanted 51-50 him, which, again, was at the suggestion of Lou Taylor. Who's Lou Taylor, again, if you don't remember? It's the lady who basically was like, you guys should 51-50 Britney and put her in a conservatorship. It's this thing I'm trying with Amanda Bynes, too. People don't need to be in a conservatorship if you're not elderly. And even maybe some elderly people don't need to be in a conservatorship. People should be allowed to fuck up their own lives. You know what I mean? It's my life. I want to fuck it up. Oh, you're going to make less money and I'm going to be less financially stable? Maybe that's a lesson I need to learn. He can also sing like her. I don't know. Let's expand in the next video. Until then, see you later. So what's interesting about that is that if you ever watch any of Britney's videos on Instagram, the videos with Sam, Britney always only says very short, fast remarks, and she's always off screen when she happens to talk. Uncanny that her best friend, Cade, can also impersonate her pretty well. Why do I think Cade is one of the people who is leaking or is a pipeline to DMZ? So in here, they'll say those close to Britney. How many people are actually close to Britney? Well, I would assume the guy taking pictures with her all the time with Sam, because if you look here, look, it's the three amigos. It's the three amigos again. Oh my gosh, look at them, best friends. Cade Hudson has been here. He actually wasn't in 2008. Jason Trawick, the one that she was engaged to, represented her from 2007 until 2011. Cade has represented her since then. He's represented her throughout the entire conservatorship. Did not say do anything, did not do shit till shit hit the fan. Convenient, you know? But to make himself sound better, he even said, instrumental in getting Jamie out. He also says that for 12 years he quietly, how do you quietly fight? Fighting inherently is a kind of a loud fucking thing. But I was instrumental in ending the conservatorship. I introduced her to Matthew Rosengart. It's like,
your friend when you're like, I broke up with him because it turns out he was abusive. And then your friend goes, girl, I fucking know. Bitch, you knew. Why didn't you fucking tell me? Oh, I thought you knew. No, that's what friends are supposed to be for. I cried to you. And then your friend goes, I thought you were just bitching. That's Cade Hudson in a nutshell. Oh, I didn't know you didn't like the conservatorship. Oh, shit, I knew a lawyer this whole fucking time. Do you want his number? I saw the documentary and I thought, is that why she's always crying? I can't with these fucking people, dude. It's like some of the dumbest fucking, like, excuses I've ever fucking heard. And then, like, what's trying to gaslight the rest of us and be like, plausible, yeah? No, bitch. It's like the comments in the fucking, like, TikTok comments that I got. What are you even saying? But now he's instrumental in getting Jamie out. I mean, you weren't instrumental when people didn't know. Just saying. So, yeah, Cade is sus. Fuck gives a shit about Cade Hudson. Who the fuck is Cade Hudson? Well, this motherfucker who evidently paid TMZ or is frequently in touch with them. I looked up talent agents. They don't have a lot of articles on TMZ. There were quite a lot about Jason, but only during the duration of his relationship with Britney. Now, Cade, on the other hand, is kind of a special guy. Well, other than the phenomenal singing skills. This guy had a birthday. It's Cade's birthday. If you go to the TMZ website, this is Cade Hudson too, by the way. Cade Hudson. He's got quite a lot of articles written about him by TMZ. Now, you're probably wondering, is it because it's about Britney Spears? No. No, not at all. I guess before he was, like, you know, well-known, Britney Spears tight with ex-fiancé's BFF. Interesting. You know, that's her new agent, new BFF. 2016, Cade Hudson, Gwyneth, Sean Penn, happy birthday to Hollywood's most popular agent. That's a fluff piece. You paid someone to write that shit. This is TM fucking Z. They're like, this guy looks like his head came out of his ass. Or they're like, file something. It's usually unflattering articles. And it's not about agents. As much as agents like to think they are God's gift to the world, nobody gives a fuck about an agent, okay? You watch Entourage, nobody really gave a fuck about Ari. Everyone was into Vincent, or whatever his name is, the guy in Entourage. But there's quite a lot of articles about Cade. And also, usually when there's something like that, they're calling him Hollywood's most popular agent. That's a dead-ass ringer for me, that this motherfucker paid for that, or he has close connections to TMZ. There's some kind of, like, quid pro quo. There's no negative article about Cade Hudson. And if you look up talent agent, other than Cade, no one ever gets a specific shout-out. Except this guy, but he died. That's sad. Cade has multiple articles, though. And they're not related to Britney, they're related to him. Especially his birthday, which I think this motherfucker's a narcissist or something. Britney Spears, Paris Hilton, and others. Oh, you can't even see it. Sorry. Notice they highlight Britney's name and Paris so that you know that Britney came. Well, if you don't remember, made a post on the gram. Birthday party in forever, and as for the pics, those were from years ago. Kind of creepy and weird that no one is talking about that. Makes no sense whatsoever. And now here's me modeling. This was the picture that was also posted on Paris's Instagram. You may think, oh, maybe people, like, misconstrued it and they just wanted to, like, you know, say, like, you know, that she was in a post and they thought she was there. No, the article specifically makes mention and makes into, you know, makes the inference that Britney was there. There's a specific line. Who came out for one lucky guy in Hollywood? Mega agent Cade Hudson. Mega agent Cade Hudson. What else tells you I have small man problem? I have small man problem and you need to see me as big man because I'm a mega agent. Sounds like you're a mega douchebag. All right. Whose birthday was a who's who? You know why? Agents make their name about being the top-notch cool person. But if Cade was smart, he would know bitches that are cool don't need to flaunt that they're cool. They're just fucking cool. If you have it, you don't have to keep fucking shouting it. So I know you don't have it. You can look through TMZ. I didn't see any other article about any other talent agent's birthday. Surprising, right? So one of his justifications for not doing shit all those years was that he said he didn't want to lose his job. Cade's job is a talent agent. A talent agent makes 10% commission. So you didn't want to lose the 10% commission? Interestingly enough, during the 12 years that he didn't want to lose his job, they overworked Britney. They basically made her work more and more. They put her in tons of programs. Yeah. He kinda seems like a dick. Let's be real. That he'll be complicit as long as his name's not in, like, you know, gonna get caught up in, like, the wind of some bad shit. Oh, and remember how I said Cade works at a creative artist agency? That's one of his clients. Which was one of Britney's posts that said, the guy in this first pic is the guy from Baby Driver. Why is Cade's client, who Britney does not know by first name, at her wedding? Sus, right? Oh, and also the picture of all the women. You might have guessed it. Drew Barrymore? CAA. Selena Gomez? Not. I don't know why the fuck she's there, honestly. Madonna? CAA. Paris? More interesting, her agent is Jason. But yeah, a lot of the guests were from CAA. Why was that something that I would have thought so? Well, agencies like to do this thing on movies now. They'll do a package deal. So they'll say, hey, if you take the costume designer, editor, and production manager from my agency, I can give you a much better rate for everyone. A little bit weird that would be happening at a wedding, right? But again, this is a wedding where they had a whole PR thing where each of these bitches right here, except Madonna, who's probably like, I don't give a fuck. I gotta redo my fucking face. Went on a circuit of talk show hosts. Oh my god, my eyes doing the screen thing. Yeah, that was really weird. So, I think this is a theory. I think these videos are all deepfakes. So I'm gonna just toss it out to you, internet, TikTok. Watch this. I'm not here to convince anyone. I'm here actually here to see if people can convince me what the fuck I'm seeing. Because this is fucking horrifying and it's fucking scaring the shit out of me. Over the weekend, I started looking up Video Shop because, you know, bitches, like, you know, they all have, like, an app. Everyone in my family, all the women in my family have an app called, Beauty App, which, you know, does the same shit, like, makes you beautiful, takes out your blemishes, makes you look skinnier. So I thought it was weird that Britney's using some app I've never fucking heard of, so I looked up Video Shop. It's a video editing app. The most interesting thing about Video Shop is that it is pretty good for green screen. Which made me start thinking, and I played around with it. I might upload some of those footages later. It was actually pretty good. The thing about Video Shop, though, it's not really user-friendly because it doesn't say green screen. It says chroma cast. Chroma cast is when you video edit it. Chroma key, you know. That's something only people might know it, but if you're more familiar with video editing, like Final Cut and stuff, you would know what chroma cast and, you know, keying is. Like right now I'm using OBS to film this. So yeah, other content creators said that one of Britney's posts was the shade hex color of, as you can see right here, this one, the dress right here, number 3, let's call it 1, 2, 3, and we're gonna call this 4 and 5 down here, okay? Number 3. So I love green screen shit. Obviously there's one behind me. You notice 1, 2, 3? It's the same. It's probably chroma key because that's why she's wearing number 3. Then you can put any design on top of it. Yeah. This is fucked up. This is the most craziest fucked up shit I've ever fucking seen, guys. Like, what the fuck? Okay. You know what? I'll take a L. Like, if people are like, oh, you're just batshit crazy, none of these look like they're the same. But no, fucking look at it. Oh my fucking god. You see? 2, 3, 1 right now? The same face. I've been noticing that. That was something I was realizing too, that she always has the same fucking face. But the longer I look at these, the more I'm like, oh shit, it is literally. I downloaded an app called Beam App. B-E-E-M. It's augmented reality. Augmented reality, if you don't understand, is, Pokemon Go. You know how you can see figures, or like sometimes like with IKEA shit or like furniture on Amazon, you can like see what it looks like in your house. I have footage. It's actually one of my videos. One of the face filters I did at the end, I added, it's a, you're a 10 butt, like I think 4 videos ago. There's an augmented reality version of me dancing weirdly because I wanted to see what it looked like, because I was highly suspicious if these were, because they're glitching. Augmented reality, which now I'm thinking, oh fucking for sure, yeah. These are all a couple weeks apart. I'm also very curious now if any of the songs mean anything. One of the songs is What a Man, What a Man, What a Mighty Fine Man. I think that's the chroma key one right here. I don't understand the Instagram. It seems like she's sending us a message, but who the fuck would okay this shit? Or maybe they don't realize it or something. But yeah. 1, 2, and 3. That would be chroma key. You see how the same dress and stuff? She could add accessories, but look at her hair. Number 3 is most oversaturated, but it's all the same roots. She has the exact same hair in actually all 5 of these videos. I've been noticing that all the dancing videos have the same hair. It's halfway tied up, blonde like that. You see the bangs like that, number 4 and 5. So, there's going to be a video that comes along with this. Basically, my video is basically saying, like, I knew something was fucked up because I saw the Jamie Lynn post. I'm like, she hates that fucking bitch. I hate that fucking bitch. Why the fuck would she post about her? So then I looked at all the dates. I thought that was, like, a post for Jamie Lynn's birthday. Britney's birthday is December 2nd. She wrote that Jamie Lynn post on her birthday. And actually, she has some of the strangest posts on her birthday. The most contradictory ones. The most that sound like it's her. On her birthday, she also posted about the... not knowing the wedding guest, like that guy Baby Driver, you know, that was subsequently deleted, obviously. And then she wrote this one post which I thought was funny, where she like says, why do I look like Jessica Simpson? And I thought she was just like a dig at Jessica Simpson, but I think she's calling our attention to these deep fakes, if they're deep fakes, because she also uploaded this. And that's the same face they all kind of make with the you know? I took some screenshots. It's freaking me the shit out, man. What the fuck? I'm probably not gonna even edit this fucking video because I'm like, oh my fucking god, what the fuck is this bullshit? This is such a fucked up thing. I have no fucking idea what's happening. I think it's actually freaking me out. I wish I didn't discover this. I'm noticing they're all having the same mannerisms. Yeah, some of them are a little bit different, but give or take, they all go up to the camera, head left, head left. This one hairspray's up here, and the chroma key will head spray. These two are the most similar, that's why I grouped them here. But you see that? Hairspray, hairspray. Face, face. Goes up to the camera. Maybe that's just her move, but let's not fucking forget. This bitch is a dancer. She's a choreographer. She fucking choreographed a dance. You think she's gonna do the same shit? And how many times do you uncannily have the same face? So this. See this? I thought it was a dig at Jessica Simpson, but that's the face. That face actually comes up quite a lot with this dancing. And this one, she was a post. It's not a video. She took screenshots. But that's the face. It comes up all the fucking time. Yeah. I took a screenshot earlier. See, they're all... there's two more. Okay, I guess I should show you right now, too. These two have the most similar dance moves to watch. Not right now. There it is. And it kind of looks like the other one where she's spinning in a circle. I don't have that fucking video clip, but like the one where people are like, what the fuck is she doing? And they slowed it down and stuff. You see? So, okay, internet. I had way much more to say. But I think this is stressing me out. Because why the fuck would anyone do this? What the fuck is up? I'll probably make a better video that's longer. But yeah. Internet, why don't you let me know? Am I going crazy? Or is there something fucking here? Do I have the video where I... it's on my page. Actually, I'll just grab my fucking video right now so you can just see. Might as fucking well since I'm already fucking here, you know? So it's an augmented reality. I didn't do a good job, but I just wanted to play around with it. See? Yeah, I'm just gonna upload this because I don't have anyone to talk about this with, and I honestly... I would be relieved if people are like, nah, you just went down the rabbit hole, you're going fucking crazy. They're all different. I don't fucking think they are, though. Jesus fucking Christ. Jesus. Oh my God. Okay. Oh, it's already recording? Okay. Ooh. So, hey, I wasn't gonna make a video today, but check this out. Look at that. So, I photoshopped the mask off that Britney. Moved it onto this Faye, Sam's sister, by the way. Wild hunch. There's something sus about their relationship. If you guys know, you guys know. It does not fucking look platonic, and they're fucking siblings. They're supposed to be siblings. Look at her eyes. The eye color of this Britney, for one thing, is brown. Look at this girl's eyes. Look at how the mask fits. I know what you're thinking. Maybe she's a one-off. I thought that too. So let's go wild here. Let's do it one more fucking time. This time, this one has its head down a little bit. Weird. Right? I don't know. Let's do it one more fucking time. Kind of looks like someone was lazy. They didn't even change their eye makeup. I don't know. There's a uncanny resemblance to me. And I feel like I'm onto something. Because I showed this to my mom. One of the videos. And I said, hey, does this lady look the same in both sides? And my mom went, yeah, why? And she could give less than two shits about all this. She does. I think she tunes me out when I'm talking about this. Anyways. And she said, yeah. So I explained to her. She goes, oh yeah, that is pretty suspicious. I'm like, isn't it? So I'm only smiling because I hate when people are smart than me and they think they get away with something. No, you fucking didn't, Sam. No, you fucking didn't. You're also a horrible fucking actor, and you have a weird relationship with your sister, or you're a horrible actor, like I said. Watch several of your videos and interviews. You have one goddamn job. Pretend like you're in love with your wife. Can you not even do that? I don't know. Watch those interviews, they're bad. But if we are onto something, I would highly advise everyone to go onto her Instagram and start screenshotting the shit out of everything, because obviously they watch these videos. If we're onto something, they will start deleting shit. Faye, for a little bit in 2020, was also blonde. Like, it amazed me how blonde she got. She got Britney blonde. Weird, right? I'll have more pictures in another video next time. There's gonna be a whole video for Faye. Faye, you're gonna get famous like you wanted, because evidently she's an aspiring model or some shit like that. Probably just not for the reasons you fucking want. But God, these people are just fucking horrible. But yeah, they got a weird relationship. If you go on her Instagram, if you've ever followed Sam, or not even followed him, I don't follow him. If you just have looked at his page, probably because he's the most famous too, his comments will pop up once you like load on her page. So you load on her page and you go to each individual post. If he's commented, it'll pop up, and it pops up quite frequently. I would say it's a good maybe 40%, 30% of all her posts, and they say, love you, sister. So beautiful. Love you. So beautiful. Fun fact, he has three sisters. He could give a shit about the other two. I don't know. Maybe he loves the one that's on a private account, but I highly doubt it. Because the other public account, he's just like, fit. Stay strong. But with this one, he's always like, so beautiful. So, I mean, I guess on a positive note, he only has the hots for one sister, which I guess is better. Incest should only go zero to maybe one. But, not that it is one, but... You let me know. Look at the pictures. Look at the comments. He comments his sister more than he fucking comments Britney. Bro, you were Britney Spears. You should just be fucking singing Lucky every day. I'm so lucky. I don't know. But yes. It's a weird relationship. Several articles, if you look up Sam, they will always be like, and he has a beautiful sister named Faye. Maybe they're related and they're just clout chasing and they just want to be like super famous together, which, okay, respect, but maybe change your game because it looks like you're in love with each other. But let's go through it one more time. I'm sorry. So this was the third one again. I'm going to go and take you back to this one. Just look at it. And again, strongly advise, if anyone thinks there is something, comment below, and also go on her page. Fucking start screenshotting. Because I can't get any more, and I'm like, my eyes hurt a little bit. Fucking weird, right? Jesus. But then again, like, always open for you guys to be like, you ain't seen shit. There's not fucking shit there. I don't fucking think so. I think there's something here. Alright, till the next video. Bye-bye. I guess ever since my last video, she made her Instagram private. A random TikToker makes a video about you and says, hey, it looks like you're kind of dating your brother. Then you make your Instagram private. I don't know. Maybe they're just two coincidences in a row. Unlikely. But, you know, people make their Instagrams private, especially when they're clout chasers like Faye Asghari. I still have all this, so. You're good. I just think it's weird. I mean, if you didn't have nothing to hide, I don't know why you wouldn't, like, private your Instagram account. I'm weird. Maybe hoping to scrub shit out. I already got everything, bitch. Like, literally fucking everything. If my ex got with someone new, I know everything about you. Everything. And I know stuff that I cannot post online. But nice try. And we're gonna go look at some of those right now. Cute, right? What cute photos. For a couple. I think someone also said on back of Sam's phone was a picture of Faye's dog. It's not a family dog. It's a bit weird. I don't remember where it is. And look at the hearts he leaves her. Not just one comment. Two comments of 7 hearts in total. 4 first and 3. Love you. 7 times. This one's the most creepy. Oh no, it gets creepier. I'm sorry. She put, forever that girl that gets really excited when this guy is in pretty colors. Oh my god. And then he put, and that girl that gets really excited to see her brother. Motherfucker, what is wrong with you? That is some Jaime Cersei Lannister shit right there. That is some fucking ancestral Game of Thrones motherfucking shit. I hope you're not related. God, I really hope for your mother's sake. God, I don't know what I would do if my children were incestuous like that with each other. I feel like I would just smack the shit out of them and be like, stop it! Platonic only! Anything less than platonic is anything more is never correct. God is watching. I'm not even religious, and I would throw in the God is watching just to terrify the shit out of them. God sees everything. God, I hope they're not related. Jesus Christ, that's fucked up. It's a picture of her on a giant-ass fork. And maybe she's touching the fork or something, I don't know. And then Sam goes, I like that fork. I really hope you guys aren't related. It's so fucked up. Because there's more. I'm just gonna show you a sneak peek, because I'm not done with Sam. I did a deep dive into Sam, then that led me to other shit. There's too much shit. It's taken me a long time to figure out how to film all these videos because I'm like, I don't know how to connect it all. So I just wanted to touch on this and let you know, hey Sam, I'm not done with you. I'm coming after you. But I have bigger fish to fry. And then I'm gonna, you know, tear into you like a motherfucker because I hate you. Did you guys know that Sam Asghari, Britney's husband, is a goddamn liar? There's so much lies everywhere. Did you guys know that Sam Asghari, Britney's husband, is a goddamn liar? There's so much lies everywhere. First, Men's Health wrote an article about him because, you know, he's all like, I'm fitness. So they wrote an article. He said that he was cut from University of Nebraska. That's not true. The registrar's office is like, we don't even know who the fuck this guy is. Who the fuck is he? Why is he talking about us? Who is he? And he's also said that he didn't move to California until he was 12 years old. See the picture in the bottom? That is the smallest fucking 12-year-old I've ever seen. Why do I think that's California? Oh, well, probably because that says California right there. It says California something. I don't know how many places in Iran have, like, you know, California centers. They're like, California is the best, not the rest of the U.S., just Cali. You're an immigrant, you know, coming to America, it's not an easy thing to do, you know what I mean? You hardly see your family, because a trip to bring the whole family out is going to cost you thousands of dollars. What would be cheaper would be the person who left to go to America come back to visit them. Maybe that's what happened, I don't know. Let's look at some other stuff. So this is the article where he said he fell in love with a woman who was raised in Louisiana, and at 2, his father left them, went to Los Angeles, trying to make it in the biggest fucking city, but okay, to become a tow truck driver. That's a big fucking move to be a tow truck driver, but all right. And then that he would join him when he was 12. Says that shortly after his dad moved, his dad just basically left their life, got married to a woman named Janice Wilson, and, you know, they haven't been good till he moved there when he was 12. Weird, because he's 5 in this photo. Oh, you guys can't see it, I'm so sorry. The candle says 5. If you look up this photo online, though, they crop it out so that the candle doesn't show. I wonder if that was on purpose. But there's a 5 in that candle. So you're saying he left this woman and he was like, family, I already made a new wifey, but I'm gonna come back for your birthdays. It's gonna cost me thousands of dollars. Or did he fly the whole family out? Which, again, would be very, very pricey. Let's go back to our favorite place, Instagram, where it's just a treasure trove of things, especially when you want to catch a motherfucker lying, right? No one keeps their lies straight. It's weird. So this is Maddie Asghari, which is Sam's other sister. I would say, I guess he seems closer to her after his girlfriend / sister Faye, because I don't know, they don't post about the one that's on a private account. So this is her saying, wishing a happy birthday to childhood photo. Throwback fun, right? Where's Faye? Or aren't there four children? Only three kids. Sam, unidentified child, one of the sisters.
Where's Faye?
And Faye and Maddie are quite close. It's not like, you know, she could be like, that's the sister I fucking hate, so I chose the one where she wasn't in just to fuck her over. It's weird, right? And also Faye's Instagram, which I can't see anymore, but before 2018 did not say anything about family. Then it heavily indicated that family was all around. I don't know how many times you need to tell people, that's my brother, that's me and my sister. I'm like, you bitches know who the fuck my siblings are. I'm not gonna fucking like put it in my caption every fucking time. I'm not gonna put like, it's me and my sister. No, I'm gonna have a caption that says, I don't know, some fucking lyric of a song. Or like, do you slide on all your nights like this? Why the fuck do I have to introduce her again? You already know. Unless you don't. Or you're really trying to create a narrative. I don't know. Just hunches. Community property. It is how assets are distributed in California. Mickey's like, you get a divorce. Okay. So, you know, when you get married, it's like yours, mine, and ours. Yeah, California take that real, real serious. What was yours prior to the marriage is called separate property. And it remains your separate property. Everything after the date of marriage, becomes labeled as community property. Okay? So, what does that mean? Let's talk real numbers and dates, okay? Sam and Britney got married on June 2022, correct? So, prior to June, Britney got a book deal in February, $15 million, wow. When they pay her, presumably, if it goes through, do Sam and Britney split the money? No, not for that one. That's all Britney's money. The contract was created before the marriage, and therefore, it is separate property. Anything you get before you're married, that's yours. Now, what came after the wedding? Well, that song. I don't actually like it. I don't know why people liked it so much. Hold Me Closer, I thought it was shitty. Honestly, I agreed with her first caption, which I think was actually her, where she was like, oh, I'm glad to be the fucking backup vocals to Elton John. And I thought, bitchy. And I thought, I fucking love it. I'm like, Britney, I love it. Because she did sound like fucking backup singer. Like, Jesus, what the fuck? What's the point of having her on there? At least the Dua Lipa one. Like, I can fucking hear Dua Lipa. Anyways, I bring that up because that came out in August. Why is that important? Well, Sam gets half the royalties. Because it's community property. Now, they also bought a house. Like, I think a week after the wedding. Technically, they used their community property to buy the house. But what community property was that? Technically, that was all Britney's money. Britney bought a $10 million house. Right? Let's add the $10 million so we just remember. $10 million, right? Technically, it's Britney's money. You know, they sold the house at a loss recently, right? Yeah, they sold the house. But if they were to divorce, hypothetically, Sam would still get half of all the royalties from the date of marriage until the date of separation. You know, that's the day they declare their divorce, if they were. He would get all the royalties from that song. Okay? That makes sense, right? Yeah. And then the sale, well, is community property. So they would split it. So they sold it for like $8 million, right? They sold it for $8 million. So they both get $4 million and $4 million. Would you look at that? Sam, if you were to leave this marriage, already leaves a little richer than he came. Now he has unidentified number of royalties. Let's just say it's $1 million. and the proceeds from the house that they bought while they were married. Because that's a profit. They, even though it's a loss, they did make money of something that they bought while they were married. Just a little bit interesting. I mean, I would probably do crime a little bit better. I'm just saying, I would just pay the, like, I don't know, maybe $100 more to get the body double with the right tattoos. But that's just me. I'm not even that anal of a person. Like, I'm just, I would do a better fucking job. Sam reminds me of, like, the villains in Scooby-Doo. You know what I'm talking about? They're always like, and I would have gotten away from it too if it wasn't for you meddling kids and your dog. And it's like, no, motherfucker, those kids are fucking stoners. You're so bad at what you do that a bunch of fucking stoner kids figured this out, and their dog is stoned. That fucking dog figured it out. That bitch over there, her glasses aren't even on. She just keeps dropping them, going, jinkies, jinkies. And don't get me started on the blonde boy and the girl. They just come at the end and take credit. They're like, well, gang, we did it again. And Shaggy, I don't think we could kill you, but I don't think he should be alive. You know when people have weddings, like, not on Saturdays or Fridays? It's usually because the venue gives them, like, a deal. If the venue is your fucking home, how much did you really save? It was, for lack of a better word, tacky. I'm so sorry, Brittany. But you know what? It's not even your fault. We all know it's this motherfucker's fault. But then again, this is a wedding that they were like, would you like chicken, fish, or steak? None. None. There's no food at this wedding. Get the fuck out. We only had the DJ for an hour, and literally we only had the bride for like maybe 30 minutes. So, get snapping. Let's get pictures of the bride. Not my family. Selena Gomez. Let's go. Madonna. People love the VMAs in 2000. Mm-hmm. That was so fucking long ago, bro. No one gives a shit about that. But he was like, get the photo. Get the photo. Photographer Matt. Get the photo. Get the photo. That's not the move. Maybe you should have just taken some pictures with your family and the bride. I don't know. I don't know. I got some crazy ass ideas sometimes. You know what I'm talking about? Looking back at the wedding video, and I thought that shit was a fucking commercial. I thought the wedding was like literally a fucking ad. I didn't realize until I was looking. I'm like, oh yeah, there's like Versace fucking everywhere. They're like Versace robe, Versace clothes, Versace, Versace. It was pretty fucked up. I looked at bitch Madonna with all her kids, and I saw one, and I'm like, oh man. But then she made out with them, and I went, oh my god. That was her boyfriend. He was the same age as them. It's fucked up. It was honestly super fucked up. I mean, it's not so fucked up with Sam and Brittany because this motherfucker looks old as shit. Look at him. 20 my ass. I think he lied. Well, that's the rumor. Oh, and for the people who comment being like, you obviously have a lot of time on your hands. I do. I do. It's a shame. Did you want to take some of that time off my hands? I like long walks on the beach and I love cake. So, we can go. If not, shut the fuck up. I don't give a fuck. Jesus. Obviously, this video is not for you. If you don't like something, that's what I never understand about people who hate things. When I don't like something, I just go, not for me. And I walk the fuck away. But like, TikTok has really opened my eyes on this, that when some people hate things, they're like, not for me. Fuck you. Fuck you. I'm gonna be here and stay miserable because I fucking hate you. Bro, who hurt you? Leave it alone. If you think I'm a sad, miserable person, probably am. Shouldn't you just be like, that's sad for you? Because I think that of you. I think, what a sad, miserable person. And I go on with my merry fucking day. But then, you know, they're probably like, why are you making videos about Sam? Because we're in America, bitch. Free speech. Except if you disagree with me, right? Yeah, I get you. I don't know what's worse about this guy, that he thinks that he's like God's gift to the world, or that he's just so fucking cheap. Like, that wedding was tacky, bro. Oh, hey there, you guys. I didn't see you guys there at all. You know, I'm just like sitting here stretching, watching my good friend Sam. Oh, I'm sorry. Is this distracting? Because this is what Sam fucking does all the time. It's fucking annoying. Jesus Christ. We get it. You are low-key a brand ambassador of like several watches. But you're not going to say you won. So you don't have to put it in an ad on Instagram. And I'm not saying anything. I'm just saying he should be careful. because people could watch this TikTok. People could be like, whoa, that's false advertising. Whoa, that's not cool at all. That's misleading. Whoa, I could go to the FTC website and I could make a report on this guy. Ooh, imagine if that happened. I don't think people would do that at all. It's the FTC website. You would look under social media influencers.
Well, their wedding was pretty much an ad, which makes me think, does it run in the family? No, not his actual family, the incestuous one. Like, you know, his family with Britney, technically. Sam seems like the type of guy who doesn't skip leg day. Never skip the leg day. For some reason, when I think of him, I think of Duffman from, like, The Simpsons, so everything's like, Asghari fitness, I am Sam. Maybe because I think he's on testosterone. Steroids, I think he's on steroids. Yeah, no, he's probably on steroids. They're all on steroids. The reason I bring all this up is because I forget, and I'm not sure if other people forget, that Instagram is still kind of a business. You know what I mean? Celebritydom is still a business. Influencer culture is where we're fucking at.
But yeah, so Britney's Instagram, it's got tons of shit. How much money does it make? It probably makes a lot of money since they keep it running.
Had me thinking. Britney used to maybe model one or two clothes, maybe every once in a while. But there's been a lot of clothes. There's actually been racks full of clothes. You know, with the deepfake videos. And like, why are all these videos coming out with her putting on clothes? Well, maybe because someone's under contract. You know, that would make a lot of sense. So I looked at her Instagram, went a deep dive, and you know what I found out? Our girl has some snarky ass comments about it. And it confirmed it. And I'm gonna show you some of them because I just think, I really like when she's being bitchy. I think it's so fucking funny, you know? I'm like, yes, yes, yes.
No. I don't think people would do that at all. It's the FTC website. You would look under social media influencers. Social media influencers actually make quite a bit of money. Just, you know, wearing shit.
Her posts do confirm it. The funniest one, I think, was the first one where she's like, well, I'm gonna have to go away, but I had to record. It's this one right here. Not sure why I'm into sharing fashion at the moment, but I like clothes and I've taken a million of videos before my move. She put, sorry, had, all caps, to post collection of fashion. Collection of fashion, interesting word choice. It's pretty brazen and bling, like, fucking ad. She put, before Donatella Versace came over yesterday, I had to model some of my favorite new tops. Yes, I'm shopping and getting ready for spring. I think 2020 is going to be fun as hell. What did that sound like? A Gap commercial, right? Like,
it's a very precise use of language. It's not, like, sloppy. Which, gave me a kick. And I thought, well, why did you have to? I've seen other videos and I've heard Sam in the background some videos, which I'll play soon. Being kind of commanding, you know, very controlling. You have to smile after the engagement, you know, which made me think, you know, everyone's like, oh, yeah, she just loves walking around and like they make fun of her and stuff about that, about the clothes. Well, if you think about it, after the one post, remember the one that where everyone was like freaked out because she was like, where she was like, oh, I got a dress, and then she was running around. The dress company did quite well. And the dress company was like, yes, we are that dress company, the one that Britney ran around with. So I'm sure that's not the only one. So now I'm wondering if they're all posts that she had to do for marketing reasons. You know, because I don't know if you guys saw the other day, she had a bunch of like outfits. She was, I don't know where any of these outfits are. Well, surprisingly, if you look at them, they're all the shopping outfits. That's where I'm at right now. It's because this motherfucker just, like, self-promotes himself so fucking much with, like, he's just so tacky. And then one of the other commenters or Britney fans were like, girl, you rich. Why are you buying stuff from Shein? Or Shen, whatever, the Chinese website that's really cheap. And then I looked at her clothes and I'm like, oh, they are that. Hmm. Unless you were being sponsored by them. That would make sense. Because they are all new clothes. And there's always racks of clothes. And one time there was a rack that fell over. Hmm. Interesting. As if someone got mad like you didn't do the thing. Plus, we'll go through her post later. Retrospect, going through her posts, she calls out lots of things that now I'm like, does she think we're dumb? Because we didn't catch on. And I feel bad. And she calls out a bunch of old dates, or she'll constantly be like, this is an old photo. Because none of these photos are me. So now I'm like, oh shit. We done goofed up. Brittany, if you ever see this, we're so sorry. I was going through something at the time when you were posting those, so I didn't actually like deep dive into it, so I'm so sorry.
Perception out there that's not even really me. I think people believe what they read and what they hear, and it's not even really the truth.
So that's from Brittany herself. So stop saying, oh no, she's manic. Oh, she's all fucked up and on drugs. I'm going to go through the New Yorker article, which detailed the conservatorship, the ending of the conservatorship, the beginning of it, the whole detail about how Britney was quietly trying to get through from it. And the fact that even the doctor that signed the paper said, I don't know why she's still in it. Nobody thought the conservatorship would last more than a couple years. She does not have a diagnosis that is been disclosed. They keep having like some rumored, like, oh, there's some, she was as like mentally unstable as they are claiming she is. Why the fuck did they work her like a dog?
It saddens me not one of you have valued me as a person. You've witnessed me how my family has been to me, and that's all you know. Like I said, I feel you all secretly like to say something's wrong with me. Honestly, my dad needs to be in jail for the rest of his life. But like I said, God would not allow that to happen to me if a God existed. I don't believe in God anymore because of the way my children and my family have treated me. There is nothing to believe anymore.
Why did they make her shoot out albums all the time, not see her children? If it was really for her benefit, why didn't they just let her relax? Why did they force her to do shows and things that she was uncomfortable with? Why did they? Because they continue to profit and make money, obviously. Like, honestly, sometimes just really think about it. Like, there's articles, there's documentaries that literally state the articles, and I have no idea. Either people just don't watch this shit and they just want to hear the headlines of stuff and they're like, well, that's what I heard. Well, maybe do the fucking research, you know what I mean? Which is like, oh, I have the article here. New York Times reported that the judge told the lawyer, her previous lawyer, Sam Ingham, that she didn't recall an order specifically preventing Britney from getting married. She literally said this. This is a judge, but he may not want to tell her that. Then her fucking lawyer said, somehow that did not come up in conversation. Yeah, it's not a conspiracy. These people were just shitty, okay? Like, they were all profiting. They were all getting a back end. And they kept her in the dark because, well, if we can keep this baby train running, why fucking not? I'll link this article. Read the fucking article, okay? No one says she has anything. People said she had postpartum. She's even like tweeted or made an Instagram post saying that, she had the other one too that happens when you get pregnant. So maybe do a little bit, do fucking due diligence before you start, like, I don't know, yelling at people online saying that they're ruining her life. But also you're kind of ruining her life by making assumptions. And when you make an assumption, you make an ass out of you and me. I'm just playing, but I'm saying, I am literally saying. And then, yeah, read this line. The defenders of the conservatorship offer a similar narrative and a grave medical diagnosis behind the arrangement that the public has no right to know. What could be so fucking bad? Honestly. The way you guys all talk about her anyways in the comments saying like, oh, leave her be. She's never going to be the same again. What could be worse than your fucking assumptions? You know what I mean? Like, do you not even listen to her? Like, that, okay, that interview was 1 year after conservatorship. We'll play audio in the next few videos. She's smart. She's articulate. It was okay if she's that mentally unstable for her to do all those shows and make choreography and continue working and act in shows and do all this. Performing is not, like, it still takes mental effort. It still takes, everything is intelligence. You're just using different aspects of it in different ways. If she was as unstable as they say, she wouldn't be able to do that. So proof is in the pudding, you know what I mean? So, and then you're so rude when you comment. You're saying, like, bullshit to me, and I'm like, you didn't get your head out of your ass, like, Jesus Christ.